called the BMW X3 M40i, and it's the first performance derivative of the company's mid-sized premium SUV we've received. And can we just stop you there? Only, we know you're about to tell us that BMW has built xDrive 35i and M40i models of the X3 and related X4 before. Yes, that's true. But the xDrive 35i was not an M-Performance model, while the M40i was only ever an X4. And it wasn't sold in the UK. Hence, this X3 M40i is something of a pioneer. It represents the top of a four-strong X3 range that will be launched in two phases. First up will be the diesel, a 2.0-liter four-pot badged xDrive 20D and a beefier 3.0-liter six-cylinder unit named the xDrive 30D. These will soon be followed by the M40i and a xDrive 20i entry petrol model. All of these have the 8-speed Steptronic auto gearbox and four-wheel drive, so the xDrive RWD examples of the last X3 are no more. Trim lines will run SE, X-Line and M-Sport, with 60% of buyers opting for the last of these, while a huge 80% of X3 customers will choose the xDrive 20D. The xDrive 30D then takes another 15%, which leaves the petrol fighting for just 5% of X3 customers between them. However, as we shall come to see, that's grossly unfair on the M40i, which deserves a far bigger slice of the pie. In terms of styling, the X3 is a gentle evolution of its predecessor. Look at the glasshouse, body shape and overall stance of the new car and you'll see the similarity to the outgoing X3, so much so that, during an off-road session where we were in a third of a train of Forzas, it took us about a quarter of an hour to realize that the lead SUV being piloted by the instructor was actually a MK2. But that's not to say the latest generation is ugly. Large kidney grills, a sculpted bonnet, LED light clusters front and rear, and more defined streaks along the X3's flanks make it look big, imposing and expensive, without it coming across as hulking in the process.